Imagine you were happily cruising along in space in your very own mining ship when suddenly you pick up a faint distress signal from far away. Checking your spaceship's digital atlas, you discover that the signal is coming from a colony on a planet called LV-426. Where have you heard that name before? Landing on this distant moon, you exit your spaceship, hoping to rescue some desperate colonists, only to come face to face with the galaxy's most formidable predator. Hello and welcome to another special episode of the Infographics Show. Today we're putting you up against the most perfect organism in the universe. Could you defeat it? You versus a xenomorph. Xenomorphs, or aliens, are a parasitic species whose real origins are unclear. Some believe that xenos were genetically engineered by an ancient spacefaring civilization known as the Engineers, or Malakak. The Malakak may have used xenomorphs to terraform planets by wiping out all large species and then starting fresh with their own genetically engineered creations. Or they may simply have been a biological weapon meant to disinfect experiments they think went wrong, or to use against their enemies. Others, however, believe that the xenomorphs evolved in a dark, distant corner of the galaxy and were discovered by the Engineers and other spacefaring civilizations. Though their origins remain a mystery, we have enough experience with xenomorphs to have learned a lot about them as a species. The xenomorph life cycle begins with an egg, which contains a short-lived organism known as a facehugger. Upon detecting the pheromones of an approaching host, the egg will awaken the facehugger within, which immediately attacks the would-be host and attempts to latch on to an orifice so it can deposit a parasitic larvae inside the host. Typically, a host's mouth is the preferred larva-laying route into a host, but given their adaptability to different hosts across the galaxy, any orifice or even a sufficiently large wound will do. Once inside, the larvae feed off of vital fluids, making the host incredibly hungry and forcing it to eat more, which in turn further feeds the larvae. Once sufficiently large, the larvae will then exit the host as a chest burster, so named for their proclivity to burst directly through a host's chest. Once free, the larvae seek shelter somewhere dark and isolated, where by some unknown biological process it is able to quickly mature into an adult drone at an extraordinary rate. Xenomorphs are a eusocial species, much like ants, honeybees, and other social insects, with a clearly defined caste system. It's thought that all members of a xenohive are females, and at the very top of the hive is the only fertile female, the queen. She is solely responsible for egg laying, and every other member of the brood is her offspring. Drones or warriors are the workhorses of the hive and are responsible for defending the hive as well as finding prey and new hosts for the eggs. A third caste, Praetorians, are only produced when a hive has grown large enough to support them. These are the most formidable of xenomorphs, with the exception of the queen herself, and act as bodyguards to the queen. However, as they mature, Praetorians exude a scent that is different than the rest of the hive, which prompts the hive's drones to attack it and chase it away from the hive. Once fully mature, the Praetorian will return and be attacked once again, and either be killed off by the hive or grudgingly accepted by the queen after suffering too many casualties amongst her drones. Interestingly, despite the hostility, Praetorians will defend the queen to the death. It was originally thought that they were the only males, and perhaps this process of being chased away and forced to fight their way back proved that they were the fittest and thus could fertilize a queen and produce a stronger hive. But after a Praetorian was observed molting into a queen after the loss of the hive's current queen, this theory has largely been discarded. Since then, it's generally accepted that much like many insects and invertebrates, here on Earth, queens are completely self-fertilizing and don't require a male partner. Taking on an entire hive of angry xenomorphs is guaranteed death. But let's say that you were pitted up against just one of these vicious creatures. How could you defeat it? And what are you up against exactly? The hive of a xenomorph is made out of a chitin that is believed to be coated with a layer of polarized silicon, which makes it very resistant to electricity and heat. This layer of chitin covers almost the entire body, with the exception of the joints and the underside of the neck, and is also extremely resistant to small arms fire. At anything but point-blank range, any caliber smaller than a 5.56mm round will simply bounce off. While resistant to heat, xenomorphs show a vulnerability to weapons such as flamethrowers, and will generally shy away from open sources of flame. Extreme cold, such as liquid nitrogen, is also exceptionally effective against a xenomorph, and it's thought that rapid changes in temperature cause the xenomorph's chitinous armor to rapidly contract and expand, causing it great pain. A xenomorph is also able to match the outer layers of its body with the ambient temperature, making it invisible to being tracked by thermal imagers. This seems to suggest that xenomorphs evolved as predators on a cold world, with little or no daylight, as this ability would have kept them hidden from heat-sensing prey. The lack of eye organs also seems to indicate that this is a strong possibility, and it's thought that xenomorphs track their prey by scent and electroreception, much like a hammerhead shark and many stingrays. A xenomorph's acidic blood poses a significant risk to any would-be would-be attackers, as it's extremely corrosive and capable of easily dissolving steel, aluminum, or even titanium. Its ability to also disintegrate normally acid-resistant plastics indicate that the blood may not be an actual acid, but rather a fluid that works to break molecular bonds in an unknown way. So how do you kill something that can shrug off bullets and will bleed acid blood on you even if you manage to wound it? Fire is the most obvious and immediate answer, and for that there's no better tool than a high-powered flamethrower. Though most nations have discontinued their use of flamethrowers due to being ineffective in modern combat, and for the very bad press they tend to create, Russia, who traditionally doesn't much care what the rest of the world thinks, has recently reevaluated their use. A 2016 U.S. Army report notes that Russia has found the weapons useful for urban and mountain warfare, despite being illegal by international law to use in civilian population centers, bunker busting, and clearing line infantry. Russia's readoption of the flamethrower has actually seen them add 4 dedicated regiments for flamethrower units in 2014, so it's time to make like a Russian fire bat and get your hands on some sweet xenomorph-destroying flamethrowers. But it's not as easy as all that, since xenomorphs have shown an incredible ability to adapt and problem-solve through creative means. Sure, you might get a few blasts off with Comrade Flamethrower, but with a maximum range of 60 feet, a xenomorph will simply retreat and rethink its plan of attack. Given their incredible stealth and their ability to squeeze into very tight places, a xeno will likely simply back off and wait to literally get the drop on you. Plus, flamethrowers have one weakness that quickly becomes obvious to most of the world's militaries. The backpacks of pressurized and highly combustive gas make for really, really good explosive targets. Remember a xenomorph's acidic blood? Well, some of them can spit it from their mouths at incredible ranges, and with its ability to dissolve most known materials, those tanks on your back aren't going to survive for long. While they won't explode as the fuel still requires heat to ignite, you're going to be left with, in essence, an empty squirt gun when a xenomorph comes to eat your face off. You might be tempted to fall back on firearms. After all, despite their bullet-resistant hides, large calibers have been proven to injure a xenomorph. But firearms require you to see your target and to be accurate enough to actually hit one once you do see it. And with a xenomorph's ability to hide in the smallest nooks and crannies and its incredible speed and agility, you're taking your chances going with a firearm. We here at the Infographics Show have our favorites amongst the great engineers, philosophers, and scientists, but when it comes time to take on a genetically perfect super predator from across the galaxy, there's really only one name that comes to mind: Alfred Nobel, the father of modern explosives. Inventing TNT in 1867, Nobel gave the man the tools to literally move Earth and set humanity down the path of bigger and better explosions. That path would eventually lead to the holiest of battlefield holies, the Mark 19 Automatic Grenade Launcher. A tripod-mounted weapon, the Mark 19 fires 40mm grenades at a rate of up to 375 rounds per minute and is used extensively by U.S. Armed Forces for their anti-personnel and anti-vehicle operations. With a maximum distance of 2,212 meters and an effective point target range of 1,500 meters, there is nowhere to hide from the rain of explosive death it unleashes. On impact, a 40mm grenade has a 100% kill ratio for up to 5 meters, with a 50% kill ratio at 10 meters, making it an unparalleled xenomorph killing tool. With its high rate of fire, if the first one doesn't do the job, the next 3 or 4 definitely will. So how would you take on a deadly xenomorph? What weapon is truly best to use against the most dangerous predator in the galaxy? Also, be sure to check out our other video, You vs. Spider-Man. Could you defeat him? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!